Welcome. In this video, I'm going to be taking a look at the Stoon waterproof phone pouch. So this was provided to me by the distributor, but they're not compensating me for this video and they're not reviewing it before I post it. If you find this video helpful and you want to purchase one of these, I'll put a link to it in the description on Amazon. And if you use that link, it helps me out a little bit and doesn't cost you anything extra. So this is a two pack of the pouches and this is how to use it, but I'll go over that. Here's some tips. It says, please test the phone bag before use. Place a tissue inside the phone bag and soak it in water for half an hour. Do not use if the tissue gets wet and contact us for support. So what they're saying is you could put a tissue or paper towel in the bag, stick it in water, leave it there, and see if water seeps in the bag. If the tissue or paper towel is dry, then you know it wasn't leaking. If it gets wet, then you know that it's been breached. It says do not use in hot springs or hot tubs. Avoid shock, crash sharp objects during use. Avoid use it under the sun for a long time. Make sure the phone bag is tightly sealed before underwater using. Store it in a dry place after use. So this thing about avoid having it in the sun, that's kind of true for your phone too. If you're at the beach, you should probably store your phone in the shade. If you're boating with this, you can set this in your boat and just kind of keep it covered. That's not only good for this bag, but it's also good for your phone to keep it from getting too hot in the sun. So let's open this up. And this does come with two bags. So if you're a single person, you can have a spare. If you have a family, you can disperse these between family members. And this does have a nice feature in that it has built-in flotation. And this will float up to 200 grams. So to open this, I'll pull these two tabs on either side, like so. Set those out of the way, like that. And then this will open up. I'll take the placard out. Looks like this has the same thing the box had. And it has that permanently sealed air bladder in there. And to test this, I'll be using an old iPhone 6S. But this will work with phones up to the iPhone 13 Max, so it'll work with the large phone too. So I'll place this in here. So I'll pull these out so this can be closed, and then these will clamp shut and it will snap, like so. So I needed to finish emptying the box. It does have lanyards in here too. Let me get one of these out. So here we go. We have a lanyard on there. So I'll turn off my light here so I have a little less glare. But this will work underwater. So the fingerprint sensor I don't think will work. But you can use the screen and the touch screen. You can take pictures. Now it says if you have trouble taking pictures, you get it in the picture mode, you can use the volume button to do that. And I just realized I have this in upside down. So let me take this out. Now the way I had it in there would work, but you can't take pictures with it. And it makes more sense to put it this way. I'll go over that in a second. So here the cameras are available on the outside. So we can take pictures. So this orientation is good. If you have it around your neck, you can just pick it up and see the screen. It's not going to be upside down like I had it when I first put it in. But you can see it can take pictures through there. So you do want to keep this from getting scratched because that could affect your camera. Now if you have a little scratched area, you could move it up and down depending on the size of your phone to get a more clear area. So I love to go kayaking, I love to take pictures, and I carry a waterproof bag with me, and I keep my phone in it. So I'll see a neat bird or something, and I'll open up the waterproof bag, I'll get the phone out. If I'm lucky, the bird hasn't flown away, and I'll take the picture, and then I'll put the phone back in my bag, because I don't want my phone to get wet. With a bag like this, I can keep this out in my kayak. I can hang it off something, hang it off my neck, something I want to take a picture of. I can pop this out really quick and take a picture. I don't even have to take it out of the waterproof pouch. And it is waterproof, so if I get some water in my kayak, it's not going to hurt it. If it falls overboard, it should float. This is also good for the beach, boats, things like that. I think this could also be good if you have an old phone and you want to give it to your kid for entertainment if you're on a car ride, like if they're watching a movie on it or something. You could hand this to them and it offers a little bit of protection, but you can easily take it out, like if you don't want a big case on it all the time. So this would also be good for keeping dust and things out of it in dust areas, like at the beach. Although, as I was saying, you don't want to let it get scratched up if you're going to be taking pictures. Sand could do that, so you want to be careful of that. But otherwise, I like the build quality of it. It's a soft TPU plastic, so it feels really good. And I really like that pouch there, so you have the float protection. So if I'm in my kayak taking a picture, and I have to drop this real quick to paddle away from something or something, if this gets in some water, it's not going to damage it. And like I said earlier, this does come with two of these, so you can have a spare, or you can give one to a family member, so that makes it twice as handy. Okay, so I have a tub of water here. I just wanted to demonstrate that this does float. So I'll put this in here, and you can see it is floating. And if I press it under the water so it's completely submerged, I can still use the touch screen there. So that's the Stoon waterproof phone pouch. That's all I'm going to cover in this video. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. If you like this video, please click like. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, I'd appreciate it if you could do that. And thanks for watching. Until next time, goodbye.